Students, let us solve the question. The question is, a block lying on an inclined plane has a weight of 50 Newton. There is an inclined plane like this, and a block is placed here whose weight is 50 Newton. That means I can say that the mass of the block is 5 kilogram. It just begins to slide down when inclination of the plane with the horizontal is 30 degree. That means at 30 degree, it just begins this motion. That means if I put the inclined plane, the block is here and the angle is 30, place it, it starts moving down. If I bring this inclination to a lower level by decreasing the angle, then if I place it, it will not slide. So that 30 degree, what is given in the question is the minimum angle of its motion. That means what? That means if I increase the angle greater than 30 degree, then also it will start moving. So this 30 degree is called the angle of repose. The 30 degree is called the angle of repose. What is that angle of repose? It's the minimum angle of the inclined plane where you place the block, it starts sliding. Obviously, if it starts sliding as, suppose that this starts sliding as 37 degree, then obviously it will also start sliding up more than 37, 38, 39, because the 37 sliding means more than that also, it will start sliding. If I decrease that below that angle, that means if I decrease below 37, suppose, then it will not slide. So we have to solve this question like this. So this 30 degree here is the angle of repose. This is the solution. Angle of repose. Why angle of repose? Because at this angle, it starts sliding. Decreasing the angle, it will not slide. Increasing the angle also, it will slide. So that minimum angle is that. Find the coefficient of friction. Now, what I will do, I will just take the free body diagram of this block. This is M, I write the block is having mass M. Irrespective of whether the block mass is M or 2M, doesn't matter much, because at the end we will see that it is independent. This theta is independent of the mass of the block. Let us see how it is done. This is the weight which will act vertical downward. This is the direction in which the normal direction will act. If and the component of this mg will be like this. I call this angle as 30 degree as theta. So this angle also will be theta. So this component is mg cos theta, and this component is mg sin theta. So with this component of the gravitational force acting on the block starts sliding. So there is an external force which tries the block to move in that inclined plane. So this is the external force. Because of the friction obviously will be acting in the upward direction. The friction will be in the upward direction. That is Fs, force of static friction in the upward direction. When you say that it is just begin to slide its motion, whenever you will find words like this, just begins, that means it is balancing. This and this will balance. Just balances it. So therefore, this force of static friction is at this mg sin theta, it starts its motion, so I'll balance these two. Obviously, I will also balance these two components, this mg cos theta and this. I will have to balance it. If I balance it, what I will get? So, first of all, I will balance the force of static friction equals to mg sin theta. Similarly, I will balance n as mg cos theta. And because, and I will divide these two equations. Okay, let us divide the two equations and see what I will get. So, interesting point is, if you divide the two equations, the m will get cancelled. Fs over n is mg sin theta over mg cos theta. Okay, I'm just writing this from the previous slide, from here only. Okay, if you divide that, then mg will get cancelled out. So, therefore, I told you in the beginning, it is independent of the mass of the block that is placed. So, finally, you are getting here is tan of theta. And what is Fs? Fs is always mu s into n divided by n. So, n also will get cancelled and you will get mu s as tan of theta. This means what? The coefficient of static friction is equal to the tangent of the angle of repose. It is what angle? It is that angle on which the block placed on the inclined surface starts moving down. Therefore, in the question, we are asked to find the coefficient of static friction, and we got this as the formula. The coefficient of static friction is tangent of theta, and theta in the question is given 30 degree, therefore mu s is equal to tan of 30 degree, which is 1 upon root 3. So this is the answer to this question. So this is the answer. Thank you very much.